Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Okay, good morning students. Good morning learners. How are you? Fine ya. Okay, happy Ramadan ya for all of you. Okay, I hope all of you are still in a good condition ya. Okay, welcome back with me with Mr. Theo. Okay, but before we talk too much about this lesson, please say ta'awud and basmalah. Wahid. Isnain thalatha. A'udhu billahi minasyaitani rajim. Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Okay, guys, we still talk about the topic of the fraction. Masih tentang pecahan. This is the last. I will share two lessons. The title is we will talk about problem solving in fraction. Look at my slide. The first is fraction of. Seberapa bagian dari a number. For the example, what picture is this? These are the apples. How many apples? Let's count together. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. There are 12 apples.
Ada 12 apples. If I want to know half of 12 apples is berapakah separuh dari 12 apel? Berapa? Separuhnya 12. So we can write a half of 12 apples. A half. What is the meaning of a half? Setengah. A half of 12 apples. Tadi apelnya ada 12. Nah, separuhnya berapa? Kembali ke sini. So you must divide the 12 apples into two parts. Jadi dibagi jadi dua. Dua plastik. Separuh untuk A, separuh untuk B. So the content in each plastic is berapa? There are six apples. Berarti a half of 12 apples are six. Separuh dari 12 apel itu ada 6 apel. So how to count? We just divide 12 divided by 2. 12 dibagi 2. The result is 6. So we will have 6 apples in every plastic. In each bag. Di setiap kantong, setiap plastik, setiap tas pasti berisi 6 apel. Because we have 12 apples. Now, one third of 15. Sekarang sepertiga dari 15. If we have 15 apples. One third of 15 apples are berapa? So we can define 15 divided by 3. Berapa? 15 bagi 3. 5. Easy.
Gampang ya. Next. By divide the number with the denominator, we will have a fraction of blah blah blah. Kita akan a part of a number. Jadi akan mendapatkan bagian dari sebuah bilangan yang utuh. Tapi syaratnya apa? The numerator is 1. Atasnya 1. Nanti lain lagi kalau atasnya 2. 2/3 of 15. Lain lagi. 15 kali 2 baru dibagi 3. Tapi kita belum belajar yang itu. 1/5, 1/3, 1/2, 1/4, 1/8. Seperti itu. Jadi hanya membagi saja. Pembilangnya, numbernya utuh dibagi dengan penyebutnya, denominator. Next. The second topic is addition and subtraction. How to add or how to subtract using the fraction? In this case, we have the same denominator. Di dalam kasus ini yang penyebutnya sama. How to add? It is very simple. If the denominator are the same number, please add only the numerator. Ya, jadi yang ditambahkan hanya pembilangnya. Oke. Okay. 6 tenths plus 3 tenths, the result is 9 tenths. Because we have the same denominator. Ya, so we add the numerator. This one. Easy ya? Oke. Okay. Next, if I have 1 plus 3 fourths. 1 tambah 3 per 4. Nah. You can change 1, ya. 1 yang tadi, whole number, ya, diganti dengan the fraction. Because we have 4 for the denominator, penyebutnya itu 4, maka we can ya change 1 with 4 fourth. 4 per 4 sebenarnya 1. Tinggal tambahkan saja. 4 plus 3 is 7. Easy ya? Ya. We also can do it for the subtraction. Kita bisa menggunakan di pengurangan. Oke, okay. We have the same steps. Caranya sama. Just operate the numerator. Pembilangnya saja. 12, 15, minus or subtracted by 7, 15. The result is 12 dikurangi 5. The result is 5. 12 dikurangi 7 sama dengan 5, 5. Ya. Oke. Okay. So, it's very easy. We also have the same step if we have 1. 1 minus 7 tenths. Nah, we must change the 1 with 10 tenths. 10 per 10. 10 per 10 minus or subtracted by 7 tenths. The result is 3 tenths. 3 per 10. 10 dikurangi 7, the result is 3. Easy, right? How about the mixed problem? Yang campur aduk kayak karang karuan. Ada pengurangannya, ada penjumlahan. You also have the same methods. You also have the same steps. Ya. Kerjakan dari depan. Ya. For the example. Ya, 10 12 minus 7 12 plus 5 12. The result is ya 10 dikurangi 7 5 3 tambah 5 3 plus 5. The result is 8 8 12. Gampang. Easy ya. Oke, okay. It's very simple. Oke, okay. 6 per 10. Look ya. Tapi ini ditambah dulu. Jangan loncat ke belakang ya, dari depan. Oke, okay. Tambahkan dulu 6 per 10 plus 4 tenths minus 10 tenths ya, 6 per 10 ditambah 4 per 10 dikurangi 10 per 10 discount, the result is 0 tenth, or we can write down 0, 0 saja ya, karena aku bilangnya 0. Oke, okay, next example 2. Jelas, ya. Oke. Okay. Anna has 48 kilograms of sugar. She gave 28 kilograms to her sister. How many kilograms the sugar are left? Sisanya berapa? Left, kata kuncinya itu. Sisa. Sisanya berapa? It is related with the subtraction. Pengurangan. Oke. Okay. 48 kilograms minus 28 kilograms, the result is 28 kilogram. Ya, 4 per 8 dikurangi subtracted by 28, 2 per 8, the result is 28 kilograms atau 2 per 8. Nah, please do the worksheet ya. I already prepared 3 worksheet for you. So please check. Oke. Okay? Okay, this is enough for today. Thank you. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.